What up, girls? How you doing? It's been a long time. I thought you can come make a memory box for my sister. She's been adopted, so we're basically making a memory box. So when she comes to find us, she knows what we've got for her. So first thing goes in. I'm talking really low because it's late and my partner and his friend is asleep. Excuse that, I've got broken teeth, so you're going to see a hole in and I may not speak properly. So first thing is what my mum did for her. Birthday card from me and her daddy. We have a card says congratulations on the birth of your baby girl. She's already someone quite special, even though she's so little and new. Her hands softly curls around your finger as she gazes intensely at you. Then to me and her dad. And though life will be even busier now with night feasts and shopping and chores, a baby brings joy and fulfillment to life. And the best part of all this one's yours, wishing you a lifetime of happiness from my auntie and uncle and my cousin. And then we have one from my parents. Says welcome, and then the name of our daughter, her full name, to the world. Our precious little girl, born on the day. Looking gorgeous, love, Nanny and Granddad. And then says, congratulations on the birth of your gorgeous little girl. And the person who, and her name. I don't want to say her name because I don't want anyone to go look for her. I hope you enjoy every day with her. And at the back it says, hi, my name is, and then her name. Lovely to meet you. And then we have her uncovering another card from my parents. Her name is, and then it's one today to my daughter. Happy birthday to my little button. You light up my world in the most specifically, I think, I'm not good at reading, so off ways. I love you today, always, and forever. Love, Nanny and Granddad. And on the back says, have a wonderful birthday. So we have those. Oh, yeah, there's another card here. For her first birthday. Just turned on her first Easter, which was last year, and it says to me and to my daughter, happy Easter, wishing you happy Easter, and then from some special people who helped me. So as you most people know, we lost the first little girl, and we had a little memory box for that for her. And I'm passing this book down to my daughter, just says, guess how much I love you. Um, which I need to write in memory of Haiti. Obviously little stories there. I'm gonna leave that out so I can put that in archive. Actually I'll write. Got some cards for when she has a child or going. I was going to do this with her. It would be a picture of her with this one escaped from the car. I was going to do, I didn't have these cards to, when I first came to hospital because I had to go somewhere else. It would be that one I would have gone with her. When she first got a tooth, she went with us at that time. She was in foster to adopt placement. That one. And also the toilet one. I'll pass these down so she can do this with her children. We have some news. We may never be grandparents when she's older. Because of what I had to go through just to stick with her. But if not, we'll choose for her to adopt and be happy for her to adopt anyway. So this book is from my partner's mate who likewise is my daughter's uncle, and he bought this especially for her show, so that I forgot to give it to her. So that's in there. We also have her little wristband when she first was born. Yeah, it's fading because it was in the light, but that goes in there. Her first dummies. That one was way too big for her mouth. So yeah. And there was a toy, yeah, toy. That was already in the box. A sleeper. So we've got, sorry, just smells like her. Got some stuff for her for when she has a little mite of herself. We've got some clothes on a teddy bear because her dad wants to be close to her, so it'd be a couple of items of hers, what smells like her, on a teddy bear. So she was really, really tiny. She was in teeny tiny clothes. So we've got this one, which is little heartbreaker. So we've got that. We've got 50 mummy, 50 daddy equals me. Then we've got my daddy is awesome. That's where I'll get it from. I know these all girls stuff, but hey. So what it's what she wore and she can pass that. She did have a I know this is gonna be a long video, but this is the reason why I've not been on, because we were fighting for a while a little girl. But she did have a coat before she was born, but because she was really tiny, it did not fit, so I had to go buy a new one, which was this little tiny thing. It was still way too big, but she grew out of it. So that's that for her memory box. We have some another memory box from her. It says her name on it. This her memory box was says a beautiful baby girl born in 2020 last year. Our memory box is my special keepsake, and then her name, and on the tag it says mommy and daddy loves me. So we've got some photos, and I'm not sure if you can tell because it was really, really low. Let's see. But we've got a first girl. There you go. She was really light hair. She was born black hair, but then it went really light brown. We've got two more photos. I'm not going to really show. Why not? If you go on my Facebook, there's pictures. So it's her and her dad. Her and dad and me. And we do have two more where she was on her own, which is in a special a picture thing with her dad. And then on the bed of table, I've got always wake up to this beautiful picture. Me, her, and her dad, we were drawing. But she weren't really paying attention because she was even one of the two. So that was our little box. This is going to be a long one, I don't care. So we've got some special cards. And some other stuff. The first one is daughter and son-in-law. You both show in your special way what Christmas is about. You are so very kind and thoughtful of that, there is no doubt. And the joy you bring to others just by simply being you is something you're most likely not aware of, but it is true. So at a time when happiness and magic fill the air, is something that perfect time to say you're so special, pair. And then it says to me and my partner, with much love and best wishes for Christmas, and I and the new year. Happy Christmas, love mom and dad. This was before my daughter was born. And then we got another one to you, daughter and partner, at Christmas with love. And it says, sending a very special couple a loving festive wish for Christmas filled with fun, joy and happiness. Because you're such a lovely pair and you mean so much. And then really it goes to you, to me and my partner. And then she say they couldn't get anything till January, which that's fine. And then it goes, hope you have a Christmas with the extra special touch. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And it says, Happy Christmas and a Merry New Year. All our love, Mum and Dad. And then it was my birthday. And these ones I kept because it says, it's this one. Have a very happy birthday. And it says to me, wishing you a happy birthday. Happy birthday, love from my partner, my daughter, and obviously our cat. And then this one, because obviously Mother's Day and my birthday is literally in the same week sort of thing. I got this one, for a lovely mum, a Mother's Day message, you deserve the best. To mummy, with love to hope this Mother's Day will be quite simple, your best ever, love from my daughter Katie and my partner. And then I got another Christmas card just before my daughter was born, and that was from my auntie. And then for my birthday this year, I got this card. And it says to Kim, sorry it's late, happy birthday. We are sorry you couldn't have your baby girl with you, but she's thinking of you. All our love, mum and dad, and the picture inside. And obviously we got a copy of her birth certificate, which I put up in the frame. And then we've got two letters from the foster carers, and it's just telling us how much she weighs, that she's still loving her food. She has such a cheeky little girl, because she's always been cheeky, always giggling. She's starting to wave to say hi. Not by a night, she knows to shake her head no. She enjoyed the Christmas tree. She loved all the presents what we got her. She's starting to army crawl and stuff like that. The other one, because we're going to get another one this year anyway. It's just to say that the hospital has discharged her from the consultant. She is now, she's still a little bit behind on her gross motor skills, but that's not what it is. And she was saying basically what she likes to do, crawling, eating a bit of spicy food, wrapping paper, because this was after her birthday. And all sorts of stuff, and she loved her birthday cake, and she eats really well and loves her food. She loves things with a bit of spice, curries, and noodles, and she loves yogurts, and she loves wrapping paper. So yeah, let me just put these back in here so it goes. So basically we have our daughter last year. We were going through a lot. We were fighting for our daughter. They let us bond with my daughter for 11 weeks before they took her away. But she knows who we are. She knows she's been adopted. They're going to keep letting her know and all that. They've changed her middle name, which I'm not happy because her middle name meant a lot to this family. But it's not because, before anyone thinks it's because we abused her or we gave her up or anything, it's not that. She's our miracle baby. And the short story, because I'm not going into details, it's just they were worried about because we've got mental health problems that it may affect how she is like in life. It's not because we beat her, not because we didn't feed her or anything. We were doing really well, but because of my mental stage and all my other problems, my partner's mental stage, it may affect her mental stage. But yeah, we fight all the way and we're still fighting to this day because I am going to put a complaint in about her middle name because I am not happy that it's been changed. They promised to keep her middle name. So that's why I've not been doing videos. I've moved. I was last year in and out of hospitals with Litland, in and out of mum and baby units, back home, back in mum and baby units, all sorts. And then near the end, the day after my partner's birthday, found out she was getting adopted. So it was just a lot taken last year. And then this here broke when I was eating a Chinese a couple of days ago. It went wobble the day after it came out, so it was on the way out anyway. But yeah, so I have, everyone's wondering, thinking, what's this? It's a bracelet what I got for my birthday. It's got my daughter's name there, which you can't really see, her birthstone, my partner's birthstone, my partner's name, and a picture of them too. I have a ring, what's got my nan and granddad, and they married date, wedding day, and forever. And I've got my daughter's name and her birthday on the ring. So yeah, that's what's been happening. Sorry that it's a long video. I will try and start doing a bit more now. There is still a lot going on. So yeah, I think last time you saw video of me was when my nan not long died and when I just got engaged. Yeah, not long after that video I found out I was pregnant. That's why I went doing much. Next video is going to be telling you about all the problems I've got because of the social services now. Which I will do another video. And then I will post it later today or tomorrow or something. But yeah, I will please subscribe, share, like, comment, and turn on your notifications so you know when the next vlog is. But yeah, and thank you for you taking time to listen to all this. Okay, sorry, I'm not used to having not a tooth there, but yeah, thank you so much. Ciao for now. Bye.